Hello, I am Ritambha Raja, and today we are here in the hostel to know something about hostel life, life away from home. And we have our hosteler Subhangi with us. So Subhangi, how's life?
Life is good. Just eat, sleep, go to college and repeat. That's how it is.
So you know why we are here today. So tell me something about your hostel life.
So just had Maggie right now. I was hungry and I had Maggie, and that's how hostel life is. By the way, keeping that apart, on a serious note, hostel life began when I did my plus two. I was to my hometown until and unless I did my plus two. And after that, I had no other option. I had to do college and I had to come out. And before coming to hostel, I was preparing myself that yes, I have to come out and I'll show my family that yes, I can be responsible by myself, I can take care, I'm mature. But inside you're also scared, because to a person who hasn't have left home in his entire life, it's tough to come out at the beginning. I'm sorry, I may be making it sound like serious and it's a big deal, but yes, it is a big deal for person who haven't left their home. You know, I've always been with my mom, dad throughout, and it was tough. But still, in a way, I was excited also to experience that independent life, that how it is outside and everything.
Tell us something more about your family.
Talking about my family, we are a very small family, just four members, me, my brother, my elder brother and my parents. So since we have always been few, we are very much attached to each other. And my brother was elder, so he left home before. So I was there with my family, and when I left, they had no child with them. So it was tough for them to have a home, because already we were few in number.
Okay, what all the things you do for your fun?
Talking about fun, it can take an entire day to narrate you what I do. Do you have so much patience?
Yes, definitely. I have.
Okay. So, on a serious note, I'll tell you, the most awaited thing is birthdays here, because that is the only time when your owner doesn't scold you. They know that, yeah, today is the day they'll celebrate, so let's give them this freedom. So, that's the day when we get freedom, and we make it a hell for the birthday girl at the midnight. There's all over cake smashing. You'll find the rooms filled with cakes, cream everywhere. And the birthday girl gets birthday bashed. So it's very painful at the night. But on the very next day also, she's pampered a lot. There are party for us, there are decorations done. And you know, girls, they are always behind getting a chance of decorating things and looking things look beautiful. So yeah, we do all those things. And at night there is party. And what we all wait for is the Barati dance we do. When there's a music on, everyone is in a party mood, dancing mood. We forget every other secondary thing. And there's a deadly dance we do. And that's how it is. Those are very fun things. We wait for it. But yeah, beside all this fun, we face a lot of restrictions. Like, we have to get inside the hostel anyway by 7 p.m. And at times, if at all, honestly, you are stuck at traffic and you give this reason, people won't believe you. They're like, she's lying. So all this thing pisses you off. But you learn to stay with them. We have a whole group, and honestly, now we have been habituated by it. Like, the owner scolds us, but for us, we ignore it. It doesn't matter. If he listens, right now, I will be out from this hostel away today. But yeah, all these restrictions are bad, but we go through it. And hostels give you a lot of life lessons, actually. You get to stay with so many people of other mindsets, so you become adjustable. Like, as you have come from out from home, you are not into an habit of tackling so many people. But it gives you a maturity, and as soon as you grow up, you have to go out and stay. And that gives you a lesson to learn. And the problem becomes less, because you know how to tackle people and how to stay with them and how to become adjustable.
So lastly, if you had an option, which life do you prefer? A hostel life or home with the parents?
Look, this is a really tough thing to answer, because as I told, both life, in a way, hostel life is also important, because there you come out of your comfort zone. And your entire life cannot be a comfortable life. You have to face hurdles. Like in hostel, you have this food and all problem. Look, I have been losing weight since I have come to hostel. I've lost a lot, and everyone is like, you're becoming skinny, you're not eating. And continuously hearing those things are irritating at times. The field I am in, and I think my future will not be something where I will get to stay with my family. But I just hope that yes, I get enough holidays to spend time with them, because we miss being there very much. But yeah, that's how life is actually, and both of the lives teach you a lot of things. Coming out of hostel life is you get attached more by your parents. You know their importance when they are not there. In the same way, when I go home and then I realize the care I get here, the friends who have just met few years before, you realize when you are not with them. So they are not being not with someone also and makes you understand their importance. So both of them are very, and I'll take a stand of what other media person, what political people say, neutrality in this. I'll be neutral because both life are very important. Both gives you good experience. So that's how it is.
Okay, so Subhavangi, thank you so much for sharing your experience. It's a lot of fun to listening to you.
Thank you so much. I hope you